So with just 2 weeks left in the regular season, the Alliance of American Football League has suspended football in Memphis. Poor Johnny Football, right? Just got the job. Just 8 games into the inaugural season, the Alliance of American Football told most employees they'll be fired today. Players were shocked, disappointed, coaches as well, of course. The league had tried to set itself up as a developmental league for players trying to make it to the NFL. A number of players from Memphis's AAF team, the Express, reacted to the news yesterday, including quarterback Johnny Manziel. He tweeted, "Just the reality of this unfortunate situation. Great concept, good football on the field, fun for fans to watch, just not enough money to go around," which had been the main problem for other leagues for a long time.
All right, Michelle, so what about it? Is this more of the same? Are we used to this happening? Did we get our hopes up for nothing or what?
Yeah, honestly, it just sounds like a lot of lack of nobody's organized. I think it was a money problem. I think a lot of people jump in head first right now, think that this is what the people want and don't really think things through, which is really sad. And Johnny was one of the easygoing guys. I was reading all the other tweets. I don't know if you guys have seen the other tweets. He was nice. Everybody else was like, it's nice to be kicked out of our hotel room that wasn't paid for. And I'm stranded for 17 hours with nowhere to go. So this clearly is somebody that didn't think things through. And yeah, it's sad, but it's just, I'm used to it now. I'm pretty used to it. So it's just, I woke up and was like, I hate that this is my reaction, but I am not shocked. I wasn't shocked at all.
Oh, how about you, Latty?
You know, I caught the tail end of the Memphis Maniacs with the XFL team, right? And so I always want the jerseys and with that stuff. And
then
I still have one at home.
I liked the team name. Right. It was good. And I was like, well, all right, the Express, all right, let's jump on board. Let's make it happen. And then all of a sudden, it just kind of fell. It's not that great. It's so funny. I work at a restaurant, and Johnny Manziel came in last night.
Really?
Yeah. And let me tell you something. He was super nice, super everything. And he was saying, you know, I'm just happy to be back playing football. Yeah. And that's all I wanted was an opportunity and everything. And he's like, you know, hey, man, just heads up. Let's keep going for it. It's like more of a positive thing. So, you know, I'm all about it. I still have hats and shirts, and I'll be sporting them all the time.
And so, Johnny Manziel tipped you.
I have to admit, I enjoyed watching some of the games. I actually recorded them on DVR. Didn't get a chance to go out there. But did we kind of expect this to happen?
Well, it kind of came out from nowhere. And I think there's an oversaturation of professional sports in some level. Can we really support that, not only locally, but nationally?
Yeah, that's a good point, actually.
Money.
But my question is, the merchandise, will they sell it for cheap, or it will be worth something because it's a rarity?
I'm going to Academy right after here. I'm getting that discount into it right now.
You have high hopes.
That's for sure. All right, we'll keep it moving here, guys. Two women accused former Vice President Joe Biden of touching them in overly familiar ways years ago. Biden says he does not believe he has acted inappropriately, but will pay attention to women's experiences. The accusations come as the former vice president weighs a 2020 bid to unseat President Donald Trump. The president has also faced allegations of sexual misconduct himself, but he has denied them all. So, Latty, this one will start with you. Joe Biden, is this a situation because he is a man who's now in his 70s, is it a different situation because of his age, or should he still be held accountable, or how do you view it?
A little bit of both. It's so weird you say that, because, like, all right, so when he was with Obama, he was kind of like that fun, like, you know, granddad kind of a guy and had, like, a great relationship. Now, since kind of Obama's not around him in his thing, he kind of seems a little creepy. He's like that creepy guy in a way. And you've seen the videos of him and the way that he kind of approaches people and all that kind of stuff. Now, the climate you're in, you can't kind of do that. And I think, was it Pelosi? She said, just act like you have a cold and don't touch anybody. So if that's what you got to do, that's what you got to do. But
some people argue he wasn't trying to do this allegedly behind the scenes. This was out front, in front of the cameras, in front of crowds.
I don't know. I don't think you get a pass by age, man.
Crash. Should he run or should he just say, I'm 78, time to sit down?
Well, it could be so polarizing, politics.
Yeah.
But I think the interesting thing will be the reaction. People that are for him, but they let it slide. People that are against him,
they jump
a winch hunt.
Right.
Because no matter who runs, it's going to be a winch hunt from one side to the other.
Yeah. That's true.
So should it get a pass? One thing's for sure, though, the pictures, it should be, there will be a lot of memes on social media. Because it's out in the open.
So, Michelle, I mean, is anybody going to be safe from these kinds of claims? Let's face it, it's a different
era. I'm glad you said that. We don't have an hour to talk about this, but I could. I'm a Syracuse University graduate, so I'm biased when it comes to Joe Biden, because go SU. I love Joe Biden. This might be a very unpopular opinion, but as a female, I'm glad Latty brought up what Pelosi said, because that's how I feel at this point. It's like, I might as well just have a no-hug policy, shouldn't touch anybody. I'm very
important. They didn't have that policy back in the day, so then how do you factor that in?
And I'm very scared that there are people out there, women and men, that will be taking advantage of this situation, if you catch my drift. And I know that that might be a very unpopular opinion, but as a female, I feel like there are definitely women out there that do that. And this one's hard for me because I've been in the same room with this person, and I just think that that's how Joe Biden has always been, innocent until proven guilty, all that stuff. We have
would
to treat everybody equal.
But would you feel that way about a politician you hadn't met, didn't go
that's
to
school? That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
My thing is, I always try to say for everybody, innocent until proven guilty. I look at everything as an individual case and decide. But it's just really sad that this is... I'm not even kidding. I'm going to have a no-hug policy. Nobody hug me after this. I'm just going to walk by.
Yeah, he's going to have an asterisk by his name for sure.
Yeah.
It's a new day for a lot of politicians as well. We'll keep it moving.
All right, let's get on a lighter note. If you think economy class on airplanes is tight, wait till you see a new airline seat designed in Italy. The Skyrider 3.0 is the newest version of an infamous standing seat. It looks similar to a bicycle seat, but with back support attached. There's that. The manufacturer says its goal is not to cram more passengers on board, but to give them another option. Okay, that would be called ultra basic economy / uncomfortable. The company is getting some interest. No orders yet, however. The seats currently don't fit the specifications of some of the more common passenger
Can you imagine
jets.
A 9-hour flight to Europe?
I don't think that reclines.
Can you imagine that?
And there's no padding, Chris. Now, you're kind of a tall guy. I'm thinking you're on big no on that seat.
Well, you know, I've lost 60 pounds over the past few months.
Congratulations.
And so I'm just trying to be able to get to the weight that I can fit in the middle seat comfortably.
You are there, my friend. You are there. Michelle, what about
Would you save money to get in that? I mean,
heck no, absolutely not. And you talk about tall, I'm 5'8", and I have enough issues being in a regular plane. I've just done that trip to Italy. 9 hours, you are very kind. More like double the amount of time. And
right,
I was miserable.
So there's no amount of money worth the savings. If you could save $200 off a ticket.
No, if you're going to Italy, you're
Latty,
already breaking the bank.
The last word is yours.
The name is great. Skyrider 3000, and that's what you get? Oh, my God. Any better could have been Space Force 2.3.
Yeah.